all day. This is perfect timing, a nice ferry. And we're going to be showing you a little later on what goes on in the studio with the band. So we'll see y'all later.
Gary-Cherone, Nuno-Bettencourt, and the rest of the guys have started work on their brand new album yet. Gary, what's up, man?
Hello? Hello? This is Gary. You gonna let me in? Yeah. Hello? Hello? It's kind of embarrassing. Wait a minute. This will get him. Guys saying more than words? Hello? You gonna let me in? Well, a little bit later on, I will be in there. I just gotta show him my ID or something.
All right.
We record and mix and do most about everything, but the most important element of the recording process would be through these doors right here. This is what we call the downtime doors. So let's see what's going on. Follow me. We're going to sneak up on Pat and see what he's doing.
Hey, oh. Bottom line.
I'm sorry. Let me explain this a little bit. This is the heckle line. This is, you can't cross.
Damn.
You can't cross this line when someone else is playing, but you can heckle, you can verbally assault them. Or you can have this a little loophole in here. This is the on-deck heckle circle right here. If I was to play right after him, I could go in here and go, hey, come on, better swing.
See, as you can see, this is serious business for us. So to be distracted by all you guys is pretty frustrating.
That's right. I predict 5 seconds this ball's gonna go down the middle. Okay, Pat, why don't you show him or tell him a little bit about what goes on?
as you can see, this is our list of high scores here, and there are only 4 people in the Millionaires Club. That means we've reached, you know, we've turned the machine over and gotten 1 million points or more. So as you can see, Nuno's at the top of the list, Gary, myself. Paul hasn't hit 1 million yet, but Bob, our producer, engineer, has...
Paul needs more practice here.
Yeah, he doesn't spend as... He spends more time on the beach than here at the studio, so...
And this is one of the many ways we relieve stress. There are some other ways, but we won't get into that. So, back to Gail and John. I just started the game. See ya. We'll see y'all later.
All right. The breakthrough album, Porno Graffiti. Let's check in with the guys once again right now.
What the hell is going on here?
Oh,
yo, what is going on here? We're trying to do a record inside. And where the hell is Nuno?
Get your hand out of
come
the
on,
way.
Get out of the way.
You guys
have a little fun here.
Unbelievable.
Come on. Well, we are Extreme, and we're here in the studio, and making a new record. So we'll play some stuff later. But in the meantime, just let us have a little fun here. Get out of here.
All right, we'll check in with them later. We also have got, coming up in just a bit, Money in the recording studio. Let's check in with Gary-Cherone and the boys and see if they have managed to do any work yet. Guys, what's up?
Okay, we're right outside the main room where the actual work gets done. We're going to go right in here and see what's happening. So there's some noise going on. Follow me. For a little kit like this, would you get this a Kmart or something?
Yeah, what do you expect? You give me 4 drums to make a record with.
Well, you know, I mean, pretty soon, if this record sells good, we'll give you
another
kit.
Wait a minute. What I don't understand is, like, I write the songs. I put all this together, and you give me 4 drums to play with.
What's this crap secret
about another successful record if I'm going to have a 4th drummer or another
Well, that
cymbal.
Was the deal. The first record, you had 2 drums. The second record, Porno, which did well, we gave you a bonus. We threw in a few cymbals. Now
well,
this
that's
record,
what I'm saying.
Depending
we
on
get
your
off like a lot, me like 3 drums.
All right, okay.
You know what I mean?
We'll get into this argument a little bit later, and I'll talk to you about that later.
Yeah, right.
We have something to say. But not only is where Paul is doing the drums here, we also sing over here. Let me show you where I do most of my vocals, and I think you can see. I don't know if you can see through there, but this Bob St. John. Producer extraordinaire.
Hey, tell you what, Gary. You want to just get out and let me do the rest of my stuff?
Yeah. I think you should do some more practicing because
right.
It didn't sound that good.
Yeah.
So So we're gonna get out of here. We're gonna let Paul practice a little bit more for the next record and see you. Say goodbye, Paul. Goodbye, Paul.
All right. Poor Paul. I think they could afford a bigger set than that. I mean, come on, Porno Graffiti was like mega, right? Anyway, coming up as we continue. They're currently off the road. They're hanging out in a studio. trying to, waiting for that creative muse to hit them. Just basically spending their time playing pinball, waiting around for the creativity to hit them for their next album. Guys, what's going on now?
We're finally here. We're all together. I've been talking to these people all day, telling them about what the record was about, but I think it would be best if you guys tell them where we're going with this record.
Well, I think I'd like to start by saying I think it's like this
is a lot like
it moves hip hop and waves as opposed to like song R&B, which kind of would be the first one.
Hey, never mind. We'll just play some stuff later. See ya.
All right, hopefully they'll follow through on that promise.
Time to... Now it's time to hear what they've come up with. Guys.
Okay, I promised all day that we'd be playing some music, so finally we're going to do this, and this is it. This is the last segment. Go for it, Bob.
Ah, yes, the music. The music. Yes. I forgot about that.
You got the right
Bob,
paper.
Turn on the music. Push the button.
Wow. Is this the right song?
No, it's the Beatles.
Extreme. So you know what she tells me? The drummer's really cute. Thanks.